Too often, teams experience fragmented workflows, struggle to locate information, and initiate meaningful collaboration. This leads to misalignment, miscommunication, and mismanagement of time, energy, and resources. Luckily, these pitfalls can all be avoided with TeamSpaces, your team's new home base for coordinating projects and centralizing collaboration, key resources, and information. In this video, you'll learn how to build your team space to centralize resources and leverage the space to coordinate work successfully. Every team hub will have its own team space, but the core framework should be the same. Clicking here will drop you into Lucid Spark where you can start building your space. Since this document lives in the team hub, it will automatically give access to everyone on the team, so there's no need to share from within the board. Let's walk through a team space template so you can get an idea for how the board should be set up. Now, the ultimate goal of a team space is to provide visibility to the work the team does and centralize necessary resources to complete the project in a very clear way. When building your team space, you should include information that will first provide focus and direction for the team, and second, help the team work more cohesively together. We view this information as two different types, reference resources and working resources. There are categories within each of these types, and those are given their own frames on the board to keep the space organized. Content that provides focus and direction is going to be your reference resources. This information is rarely going to change through the span of a project. Material that falls under this category is going to be your roster, project goals, and support content for the project. Your roster and project goals are typically going to be added directly to the board and should be filled out before your first meeting with the team. Everyone who's included in your team hub should be added to the roster frame. Provide a name, photo, role for the project, and maybe even a fun fact. Ideally, you'll want to provide enough information so that everyone knows who's the owner for each deliverable and process. The project goal section should communicate at a high level what you're trying to accomplish, the metrics you're tracking, and why the project even exists. If you have dashboards you reference weekly and expect the team to be checking them, copy and paste the URL within this frame. And finally, the support content frame should have links to documents that provide more context. Things that fall into this space are going to be your project briefs, links to communication channels, process documentation, and feedback. When possible, link Lucid documents here so you can expand them to review without opening another tab during your team syncs. For documents that the team may need occasionally but aren't visiting weekly, move them from your Lucid homepage into the team hub rather than including them in the team space itself. Now that the team has what they need to focus, it's important to ensure that everyone is set up to work cohesively together. That is where working resources come into play. This content is susceptible to change and needs to be reviewed and updated frequently to stay aligned and assess risks or blockers. A few examples of these are working agreements, deliverables, timelines, and project updates. The working agreement and deliverable frames should be completed during a team sync where everyone can discuss plans and commitments together. Working agreements will establish the way the team interacts and are intended to help people work cohesively. Take about 5 minutes in your first meeting to have everyone jump into a breakout board to ideate on what these team norms could look like without cluttering the team space. You'll want to keep the agreements to about 5, no more than 7, and they should typically relate to areas your team struggles with. Have the team vote for their top 5 and then copy and paste those to the main board for easy reference. Revisit these working agreements with the team during your meetings to ensure things are working smoothly. The deliverable section gives visibility to what everyone is actually building and committing to. During your first team sync, take 5 to 10 minutes for the team to ideate on deliverables in another breakout board. Then, tag all the ideas that the team knows are impactful and can easily be delivered with a yes. For any ideas that the team feels are impactful but may need to be researched a little further, tag with evaluate. Sort them into categories and then pull them into the main board. For the ideas that need to be evaluated, add a comment to the sticky note with an at mention for the owner to follow up in the next meeting and click assign task, then assign. As those deliverables are completed, Everyone will add links to those deliverables here to make it easier for everyone to access in one place. For the team to work effectively, they also need to know their time constraints and dependencies. Use a timeline and cards to visualize milestones and to plan out the work for the deliverables. If there are a lot of moving pieces and deliverables, use a dynamic table to provide an overview of the different work streams with deadlines. The project updates frame is to communicate everyone's progress on the project and should be addressed at every team sync. This is where you'll include links to your Scrum ceremony boards, meeting documents, links to task management platforms, and samples of work. For status reports on a temporary project, create a breakout board within the team space and add a dynamic table. This table will showcase the deliverable owner, the deliverables, the status of them, and a space to add sticky notes to ask questions. With every new meeting you have, you can just duplicate that board and change the date for the team to edit. This will give you a repository of the work completed all within one Lucid document. For functional teams that are always working together, therefore, we'll have a constant stream of projects, add the dynamic table to a separate Lucid Spark document and drop that link directly into the board. You'll then use the breakout boards in that separate document to build out your repository rather than putting it directly in the team space. No matter how you use your team space, you should always leave room for new ideas and flexible live collaboration. This could look like brainstorming, planning, or improving processes. To keep the main board organized, create a breakout board where the team can easily share ideas with Lucid Spark or switch to Lucid Chart to optimize or build out a process. As ideas and processes expand, lasso the content, copy, and paste it to its own board within the team hub, ensuring that everyone has the necessary documentation without creating more noise in the team space. Now that you know how to build a clear team space and how to leverage it to coordinate more effectively with your teams, jump into your team hub and start building your own. To learn more about the features used in this video and how to apply visual collaboration to your business, visit us at Lucid Training Labs.